classification and evolution of organism. You know, the animals and organisms are varied types of character. So the animals are classified into based on similar character. It helps to identification of animals. They classify into similar character in organisms. It helps to identification. They also separated, classified some of the special characters. They are cell structure, body design, and mode of nutrition. So some of the animals have some of the adaptation for depending on environment. It is also called evolution. They also have some of the special character depending on environment. It is called as a evolution. Evolution is occurs in slight changes. Before modification, the animals are called as a primitive or lower organisms. After modification, it's called advanced organisms or higher organisms. So the primitive organism is simple body design. Advanced organism has complex body design. Animals are classified into several kingdoms. So the kingdom also classified into many criteria. The phylum and division, class, order, family, genus, species. You know, the species is basic criteria for classification. It is a basic unit for classification. After classification, they also have some problem because every organism is named by some of the local languages. So the classification is very difficult to scientists. So the scientists form some of the special name, scientific name. So at the same time, the scientific name is also have some of the rules. They also example for Homo sapiens. In Homo sapiens, the first word is genus. The second word is a species. Genus is a capital in letter. Species is a small letter. By kingdom classification. You know, the traditional system have two kingdom classification. One is a chordata, another is called a non-chordata. Today we will see about five kingdom classification. The five kingdom classification is derived from Robert Whittaker. He is a scientist. In 1969, the animals are classified into five kingdom. They are Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, Kingdom Animalia. So the animals are classified into some of the special characters. They are body organization, body symmetry, body cavity, germinal layer, and body segmentation. Unicellular organisms like Paramecium and amoeba. In Paramecium amoeba, nutrition, digestion, respiration, and reproduction is carried by single cells. So it is called as a protoplasmic organization or unicellular organization. Second one is called as a cellular level of organization. You know, like multicellular organisms like sponges, they also have many cells. So many cells joined together or aggregated together, they perform particular function. So it is also called as a cellular grade organization or cellular level of organization. Next one is called as a tissue level of organization. You know, some of the organisms like jellyfish, they also have some of the tissues. So many cells arranged together, they form tissues. So it is separate tissues contained in jellyfish. They also have well developed established coordination function. So it is also called as a tissue level of organization or tissue grade organization. Tissue organ level of organization. You know, some of the multicellular organisms like planaria have specific organ like eyes, mouth, etc. But it do not contain complete organ system. So it is called as a tissue organ level of organization. It is also called as a tissue organ grade organization. You know, some of the multicellular organism have specific organ example is human and frog. So they also have well developed organ. So in this organ is performed various function. So it is also called as a multicellular organism. So it contain organ system level of organization. Body symmetry. The animals are separated by central pylon. They formed into hind halves. It is also called as a body symmetry. You know, human, cow, butterfly and some of the insect also separated by central pylon. They formed into two equal halves. It is also called as a bilateral symmetry. Bi mean two. You know, the multiple pylon is occurs in some of the lower organism like starfish. So the organism is separated by central pylon, I mean central multiple pylon. They formed into many hind halves. It is also called as a radial symmetry. You know, some of the lower organism like amoeba, paramecium, sponges, you do not separate into two equal halves. It is also called as a asymmetrical animal. They also have asymmetrical body structure. You know, during embryonic development, they formed into three germinal layer. So three germinal layer also developed into specific organ like higher animal. They separated into develop into stomach, lungs, brain, etc. So in multicellular organism, the germ layer also have three types. They also have endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm. So ectoderm is outer layer, mesoderm is middle layer, endoderm is inner layer. So the animals possess three layer. It is also called as a triploplasty. Some of the lower organism have only two layers. The outer is ectoderm, inner is endoderm. Diploplastic animals also have only two layers. One is ectoderm, another is endoderm. It do not contain mesodermal layer. So it is also called as a diploplastic. Diplo means two, plastic means layer. Example is jellyfish and the coral reef. Next we'll see about body cavity. You know, you make cross structure in some of the animal, you see the body cavity. The body cavity is located between body wall and gut wall. Same time, the body cavity is lined by mesodermal layer. So it is called as a true body cavity. So it is called as a eucoelomate or eucoelomate, because they also possess a mesodermal layer around the body cavity. Example for eucoelomate: annelids, molluscs, arthropoda, I mean arthropods, echinoderms and chordates. You know, in a pseudoecoelomate animals contain body cavity, but the body cavity is not lined by mesodermal cells. So it is also called as a pseudoecoelomate. Pseudo means false. Coelomates means body cavity. They have false body cavity. Example is Ascalminthes. Acoelomate. In some of the animals, it not contain any body cavity. It is called as a acoelomate. A means option. Example is Porifera, Cnidaria and Platygalminthes. It do not have body cavity. So it is called as a acoelomates. In some of the animals also have repeated unit of segment. It is a smaller and repetitive segments. It is also have body segmentation. Body segmentation is occurs in some of the animals. For example, annelids, earthworm.